just how good are the new Brooklyn Nets? With the superstar tandem of KD and Kyrie finally healthy, surrounded by a fringe all-star in Caris LeVert, the Nets have put together a top title-contending roster for the first time in franchise history. This video breaks down how lethal their dynamic duo's looking, shows you every weapon making the Nets scary, and stay tuned for an early prediction of how far the Nets can go in the postseason. If you're already subscribed, welcome back to D-Flow Hoops. If you're new here and a basketball fan interested in NBA rankings, predictions, and stories, you came to the right place. Please subscribe and click the bell so you get notified every time I post new content, which is at least twice a week. Antoine earns the shout out for comparing Malachi Flynn to a point guard version of Jason Tatum, and Malachi's release definitely looks a lot like JT, so that's a great answer. The question's on its way for next video's shoutout, where by commenting your answer, you could be mentioned in my next video and compete for yearly awards. The top five on the Community Speak shoutout board at the end of 2020 get yearly giveaways, and everyone goes back to zero in 2021. You're not often going to find that an NBA preseason game becomes a trending topic that the entire sports universe is talking about, but that's exactly been the case for the Nets in these first two preseason games, Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant, a top two duo in the league with a combined 16 All-Star selections and 11 All-NBA selections, took the floor for the first time as teammates. KD missed all of last year with a ruptured Achilles, and Irving was limited to 20 games and had shoulder surgery. The former two-time league MVP Steve Nash roamed the sidelines as a rookie head coach and seemed to have the ear of his two superstars. Debatably the most dominant factor of Kevin and Kyrie being on the floor at once is the ridiculous amount of space they open up with their combined scoring abilities. As you can see here, when Irving throws it into Durant for this ISO in the high post and spaces the floor, KD has about 10 feet of space to work with, and looks like that for the Slim Reaper are a layup, with two megastars leading the way, and every player other than DeAndre Jordan being a three-point shooter. If defenses decide to trap anyone in particular, they're going to give up a three-point shot. Another thing making this 2021 Nets team beastly is the chemistry between the two high-ego superstars has developed right off the bat, something that's been surprising given the off-court drama both Irving and Durant are prone to create. Even though Kyrie was in the wrong and hurt LeBron's feelings by saying Durant was the first teammate he's ever played with who he can trust in the clutch, that kind of statement from Uncle Drew bodes well for the chemistry of he and the Snake, as twisted as it may be. He's made headlines recently for both that comment you just heard and for boycotting interview obligations, but here's the bottom line for Kyrie. We know he's a top three guard when he has his all-star drive, but can he stay out of the media and focus on basketball? If he does, then Brooklyn's a top title threat. Another component that'll determine how far the Nets will go in the playoffs will be if Kevin Durant can regain the status as a bona fide top two talent in the league. Before his ruptured Achilles in the 2019 finals against the Raptors, there was a fair percentage of people arguing that he was the greatest player on the planet. People were rightfully upset when I predicted Brooklyn would be sixth in the East this year in my standings prediction, and I'll be the first to admit, after watching the chemistry they seem to have under Steve Nash in the preseason, that I regret not picking them as a top 2-4 team in the East. However, even if the regular season turns out to be a chemistry adjustment on and off the floor, and things start slow for KD and Kyrie, this team's star power makes them the definition of built for the playoffs, and you're about to find out another big reason for that. Around that potentially all-time great duo, the Nets are headlined by an up-and-coming young sensation in Caris LeVert, who's steadily increased his scoring annually over the course of his four NBA seasons. After Caris was the primary scoring option for Brooklyn last year, with Uncle Drew and Easy Money Sniper sideline, the 26-year-old LeVert will now be the team's third scoring option, and here's why that's terrifying for top contenders in the East. Come the playoffs, you need scorers who aren't one-dimensional, and that can develop offense from any area on the floor when the defense tightens. LeVert can seamlessly shake defenders with his handle, and then either pull up for shots from beyond the top of the key, or attack the basket with abandon, so he'll take a ton of pressure off Durant and Irving. Caris has an elite combination of perimeter abilities and quick twitch athleticism, and if he can take the next step into a 20-25 point score per game, Brooklyn becomes impossible to deal with. With three elite shot creators running the show, the strength of this Brooklyn team is their star power, and that could end up taking them through to the finals, where we could maybe see a duel between Irving and LeBron, which would be straight popcorn. Stay tuned for my official 2021 Nets prediction in the last segment of this video, but let's quickly take a look at Brooklyn's depth. Spencer Dinwiddie averaged 21-7 for the 7th-seeded Nets last year. Now he'll move to the bench to become the 6th man behind Kyrie and instantly become one of the best backup point guards in the league. Meanwhile, the 3-point contest champion Joe Harris can snipe from behind the 3-point line with the best of them. He's been a top marksman in the league for a while now. At center, DeAndre Jordan may be past his prime days with the Lob City Clippers, but he can still block shots, rebound, and dunk with diminished hops. Nonetheless, he'll be a useful threat inside for the Nets. So while those players in LeVert, Harris, Dinwiddie, and Jordan are solid pieces around the dynamic duo and make Brooklyn an incredible team 1-6, I do worry about the 4-5 other players in the rotation. Sure, Landry can shoot, and Luau Cabarrot's been a decent 3-and-D presence at times throughout his career. Recent veteran pickup Jeff Green can give you 10-plus points on occasion, but the lack of bodies Steve Nash can trust to produce could cost Brooklyn some regular season games, but of course, stars mean a lot more than depth in the playoffs. Right before my early predictions for this team, quickly I have to break down the significance of Brooklyn finally having a title-contending roster. Even when the Nets organization had success in New Jersey in the early 2000s, making back-to-back finals appearances in 02 and 03, those were miracle runs where they were predictably taken care of by super teams like the Lakers and Spurs. Now the Nets are that powerhouse who are expected to have success, which is something the organization has never experienced since it became an NBA team in the ABA merger 44 years ago. So will 2021 be the first championship ever for the Nets organization? Here's my prediction. Something I haven't broken down for you, but is crucial to how far the Nets will go, is KD's impact defensively, an end of the floor in which he can take control of the game on. Head coach Steve Nash had some thoughts about Durant's value recently, saying, quote unquote, "Kevin will offensively play all five positions and potentially guard all five positions." Teammate and friend of K-Squared, Torian Prince, took it one step further, saying, quote unquote, "We could open with us playing Kevin at the one. While I'd rather personally see Durant's wingspan and sneaky strength guard the five spots, it's clear the Nets are prepared to get funky, and they're ready to break the positional barriers if the situation calls for it." Nash has preached for many things so far, but flexibility in what should be a long-term team-building process is perhaps the most paramount in his eyes. At the heart of it all is Easy Money Sniper, a man who's likely the most versatile multi-positional talent in the game today. Kevin can either be the role man, where he was among the 92nd percentile in 2017-18, or as a ball handler, where he can maneuver through screens. He can also block shots in big moments like a center. Over his 3-year Warrior tenure, Durant pinned 1.2 shots to the glass per game in the postseason. Did I mention he's perhaps a slightly underrated playmaker? So, while some have questions of whether or not the Nets can guard Anthony Davis because of their lack of a strong big man, maybe Davis would have the edge whenever he could bully Kevin out of the way, but the Browns' attempts from beyond the top of the key I think would be shut down by the awareness and wingspan defensively from the Snake. Kevin's return into a top-notch caliber talent is going to make the pack of NBA contenders a whole lot more intriguing, and I think this team at the very least gets past the second round and makes a conference finals appearance. They likely have to take down the Bucks, Heat, Celtics, or Raptors to get through the finals, and the Nets' star power is certainly capable of taking them down and going to the promised land. It's too early for an exact playoff prediction, but I'll take back my asinine prediction in my standings video where I pick Brooklyn 6th and predict they'll finish with the second best record in the East. But where do you think the Nets will finish in the East next year? Best answer gets next video shout out. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at DFlowHoops for updates on every video I post and more. That's at DFlowHoops, links in the description. Keep watching some of my recent uploads. This was DFlow. Have a great one, and I'll see you next time.